Hi, this video is especially made for an Akai Force user in the Akai Force users group, and he asked in a comment why there's a difference between the screen and the pads when editing a key group after auto sampling it. So I'm going to show you that now. First I'm going to set up the auto sampler. I'm not going into it too deep. I'm going to sample a sound from the Axis Virus. Okay, first I want to make sure I have audio. Okay, then I can set up the auto sampler. I want to have one octave, nothing too fancy. Notes right, set to 3. That's the semitones between notes. Okay, I want to have 2 layers for this example. Looping, yes, okay. Some people say X-Fade works, other people say it doesn't. I don't know, I leave it off. Make current track, now I want to have a new one, okay. Okay, it's finished. Now, if you have a look at the key group that was created, this is the edit screen. You see 2 layers, one at 64 velocity, one at 128. And when I play, you see the different samples. Okay, I will stay on this one for now. What I think a user did was looked at this screen, thought I want to change the looping point, but I don't know how. Or perhaps he knew, but not in the detail he wanted to. So I will skip the screen for now, go to the sample edit, because what the other thing he said was he listened, and when he touched the screen he listened to the sample and it was different on the pad. So that isn't possible on the other screen, so it must be done here. And if you listen, okay, and if you press this button, it loops around the same point. Okay, what I then think he did, it's all, I assume, not too much, hopefully, is change the looping point, and then, but the first part just skipped. Okay, that's not what he wanted. So I think what he did was check this this option, that's loop lock, and then you get a handle and you can change the loop itself. Okay, now if we hear on the screen, say this was what he wanted. Now he pressed the pad and it was like before, so he didn't understand why this happened. Okay, I think you have to see this screen as the screen where the result is showed from the auto sampler, and what you see of what you hear on the pads is the key group itself, the result. So you want to skip this screen when editing the key group. Rather, go to the key group itself. And now you see, because the option was ticked on the other screen, it enabled the same looping marker. But if you want to show it just in the key group settings, it's loop lock is set here. So when it's on, you don't see it. When it's off, you see it. Now we're here, we set 0 snap to on, okay. And when you make an adjustment here, you will hear it. But first I want to make sure that I always hear this sample. How do I do it? I set the velocity to 64, half, okay. And now when I change the first layer, which is velocity 64, and I drag it over here. Okay, Now it does what I expect it to do. But now I need to find the right looping point. So it's always nice to have a sustaining note that sort of sounds the same. Okay. Well, when I look at the waveform, I normally just check the end and the beginning, and then find a nice looping point. Okay, that's not really the same. It should be about the same, but it's not. It's because it's looping over there. Okay, much better. Okay, so this is how you change the loop points for a key group. And you can change all the different layers for all the velocities. Okay, it was intended for a user, but perhaps you benefit from it as well. So I hope you enjoyed it, and see you in the next one.